It was a great college basketball game today against two really, really good basketball teams. Both of us came ready to play. Obviously, with what happened in Fort Wayne, with that outcome, there was no doubt in what that South Dakota State was going to have an edge to them and be hungry for the game. They took care of business last week and through the rest of the league play to position themselves to still be in the league race. At the top of the race, despite splitting last weekend, and we're kind of in a different position as we battle for that. But still, we both had great game plans, great game, and unfortunately, second half, I thought South Dakota State really raised their physicality, played a very, very physical game. I think that slowed our cutting and we weren't as good with our ball movement, and I think that affected our shooting percentages in the second half. Probably 21 hours of travel yesterday may have had a little bit of effect, but I'll be honest, man, I swear I don't know these other teams that I'm not in their locker rooms, but I swear I got the toughest team in this league. I can't imagine anybody tougher from what we've been through with our travel this year. I mean, every single trip, we've had a snow on one end or the other. We've had a delayed or canceled flight on every trip. We went on to three different flights. They took us off our third plane last night because there was too much fuel on the plane. And we're still in Chicago at 11 o'clock Central Time, which is midnight our time. We haven't even started to get here. And not a peep out of our guys. Just, they're on a mission. They're coming up here. They're going to play a game. They know what it takes. They know what Summit League travel is. They know there's going to be adversity. And they know there's going to be even more adversity when you show up here on this court where there's great tradition. And I'll tell you what, our program, too, and it probably starts up with me because I've been around a little bit, but going all the way through the bottom, there is not more respect from our program for any other program in our league than this one. I mean, what a class act, and just a great winning tradition. And man, that was the show Mike Dom put on tonight, particularly in that second half, just the resilience he showed.
John, was there, not to minimize the fact that you guys just lost a game, I know you really wanted to win, but was there kind of an appreciation tonight for Mike Dom, John Concher, the careers they've had going at it kind of one last time?
Oh, and that's what I said. I mentioned that with the great college basketball game. Obviously I hope we play, in the tournament again. I mean, I'd love to play this. I mean, obviously there's probably some better matchups we both would rather play other people, but like, it's a fun game. And to think back and reflect that these fans have been able to watch two of the best players, at least in my time, you got to throw Nate in there, but those three guys are, during my 8 years, are the three best that have been in this league by far. Now, I don't know, going back, there's some really, really good players, but man, and the numbers that they both have, and different type numbers, different style of numbers, and they're totally different players, but freakish in terms of their numbers and what they've been able to do. And John is gonna join Mike probably next game in the 1,000 rebound club, to have two guys kind of going through that. When you look at that list, was there like 105, 110, something like that? And that two of them were coming through the Summit League at the same time is pretty cool. And what's even cooler with all that stuff and where college basketball is? You got two of those guys that could have this last year gone and played for any program in the country. They could have been playing in the Duke North Carolina game last year. Both those guys would have been happy to take them, and neither one of them. Peep, they love their schools. They love their programs. They love the tradition. They love what they've been a part of, and they're going to leave, and someday there may be some bronze statues of both of them there for all that. But, man, I just love that. That's great. That's college basketball right there.
As far as trying to stop Mike Dom tonight, how much of it was just, him kind of overwhelming you, being really good? How much did you think you guys could have done things differently or what have you?
Keeping him off the free throw line is what you really want to do, and that's really challenging.
11 isn't bad.
Yeah, but when you're committing two guys to him a lot, that's a lot. And some of those are on second chance and things like that. you know, you're probably not going to stop them. If you look back historically, and this is maybe sad or maybe just some of the unique game plans we've tried to put in, that's one of the lows he's had against us. I mean, he's dropped some big-time numbers against us with how we've tried to defend and different styles of defense we've tried to throw at him. But, you know, it's going to be hard to really, you know, you got to have just a true matchup to really, really defend him. You know, if you're trying to run guys at him, zone, kind of throw the kitchen sink, which we've done at him, it's going to be really challenging to make him really inefficient. And, you know, he was obviously engaged tonight. I mean, we beat him by 16. We're up 26 at a point at that. Like, he was going to be engaged. He hadn't had that happen a lot in his career. And, you know, he brought his best.
Well, I know there's still a couple games left, but looking ahead towards when the tournament does get here, do you feel like your team has shown itself that they have a shot to win it? I mean, it looks like this bracket
no,
in the top
no
half
doubt.
Looks pretty good.
No, I love this. I love this group. I mean, this group reminds me a lot of the 2016 group that you know, won the league or tied the league with South Dakota State coming on the stretch, except for I think we're probably a guard or two deeper. And so, you know, the young guys, the newcomers, they've kind of gotten a flow and a rhythm. I think we all want more consistency from guys. But we got, you know, a deeper bench to go to for guys to really step up and play. And, you know, when you got two seniors like John and Kaysen who've been, you know, so good. And, you know, Kaysen didn't have a great shooting night tonight, but he's really had a phenomenal year and changed his, I mean, raised his game. I mean, he's an all-league player right now. If he doesn't make all-league, something's wrong with this league. I mean, he's shooting 20% less of his percentage shots from three, and yet his efficiency's gone up. He's a 50-40 guy, you know, and right now we're sitting, I guess we're still in third, I don't know, we're in the top four. You know, and with John, I mean, those two guys have been really, really good players.
Beyond your team, I mean, does it look like this tournament, all of a sudden North Dakota State has come up, Omaha's had a good year. I mean, it looks like it could be a fun tournament.
Yeah, I mean, it'd be a lot more fun if we play a game or two in it. But I agree. I mean, it seemed to be like that every single year, you know. And as good as South Dakota State is, you know, they've lost two. Now they're on the road. League tournament doesn't tend to be like that. But you know, I mean, they're really, really good. But man, Omaha's really good too, and Omaha's playing a little different than they have in the past. I mean, still they have that tempo, but they have a really great ability to win close games. I mean, if you look statistically at what they've done in overtime and close games, you know, Zach has been phenomenal. Powell's had a great year. You know, they just. And Hans done really, really well. Mitch has. I mean, they got a really good team. And I haven't seen North Dakota State in a while. I know we stole one from them, you know, early in the year. But they have a couple more guys healthy to play, a little bit deeper bench. And, I mean, they always have their team ready in tournament time. They can go with that grind-out style. And you know, they're kind of tournament built with how they play that style. So, yeah, it should be a great tournament. You know what's really disappointing, though? Is that there's nine really good teams and we're leaving somebody home. That's really disappointing. I really hope that our league will change that. I've been pushing for that. No one should be left home in this league. It's a basketball league. It's a great basketball league, and anybody can beat anybody. I don't know who ends up being left home this year, but we need to change that because, you know, everybody needs to be a part of that tournament. You know, and obviously, you know, I'd rather have the tournament in my backyard. I'd love to have a home court advantage of that. But, man, our tournament's phenomenal, man. Packed house, a lot due to the fan base of South Dakota State, but it's an awesome tournament that I love to be a part of, and it's a shame that somebody's left home this year.